The way Elon Musk is treating Mother Earth is a disgrace. Elon calls himself an environmentalist.
I speak as someone who is very much an environmentalist.
But everything he does is destroying our planet. Case in point number one, Starlink. Starlink is Elon's completely insane project of sending up thousands upon thousands of low-orbit satellites into the Earth's atmosphere. These satellites beam electromagnetic rays down at every corner of our planet, creating what essentially looks like an electromagnetic prison around the Earth. Now, there are many concerns connected to these EMF-emitting satellites, one of them being the impact upon human health, because a growing body of evidence is showing that while this radiation is non-ionizing, it can still pose great, great risk to human health.
My name is Dr. Angie Kolbeck. I've been reviewing the studies showing the impacts of wireless radiation on our health, and there are now thousands of studies showing the following adverse health impacts to wireless radiation. Cancer, oxidative damage, DNA damage, DNA failure.
Now, Elon of course tells us that we should definitely not worry like at all about these satellites causing any damage whatsoever to the human body.
So there's no concern whatsoever with the radiation that's caused by those things?
That is not going to cause DNA damage.
So
don't worry about it.
What concerns people is the unknown.
Sleep easy at night. Don't worry about your phone. It's fine.
It's almost like Elon has some sort of commercial interest in keeping this EMF effect on human health on the backside. Now, we could debate for hours and hours on end on whether or not these satellites or EMF in general causes any sort of negative effects on the human body. However, what can't be denied, not even by Mr. Musk himself, is the effect that these artificial EMF waves have on all the wildlife on our planet. It's been long known that electromagnetic pollution by humans disturb the biological functions of the planet, such as hampering development, survival, and navigation of insects and bees. Most animals have highly specific vulnerabilities to EMF due to unique physiology that depend upon and constantly use the Earth's static geomagnetic fields. Animals use these for seasonal migration and orientation, nest and den building, mating, reproduction, offspring care, food finding, territorial defense, simple daily and seasonal circadian rhythms, and even longevity and just general survival. Bees, for example, will normally navigate using the Earth's geomagnetic fields. When this magnetic field is disturbed by the increased EMF waves emitted by, for example, Starlink satellites, the bees get disorientated and at the same time their immune systems begin to collapse. This has been documented over and over in the scientific literature, and it might be one of the major causes for the current beepocalypse that is currently raging through the planet. The scary thing about all of this is that if the bees die, we die. Without the pollination provided by bees, our entire ecosystem collapses. But it's not just bees. We are constantly discovering new areas of our biosphere and wildlife, which are seriously disturbed and weakened by the electromagnetic pollution put out by all these satellites and the Starlinks and everything we have out in space. What makes Musk's Starlink particularly dangerous in this scenario is that the satellites sit much closer to Earth than standard satellites, and in much greater numbers, creating extreme stresses for all natural life systems on this planet. So ask yourself this question, Mr. Musk. Do we really need more electromagnetic pollution than we already have? Do we really need to be able to watch Netflix out in the jungle in Zimbabwe or do our Christmas shopping at the top of Mount Everest? Are these really things that humanity desperately needs? If Musk was truly the great environmentalist that he claims to be, he would ground all of these abomination Starlink satellites right now and work in ways where we could support the bees, the birds, and all the natural life support systems on this planet. Which brings us to case in point number two, Tesla. Surely Elon's Tesla project is helping the environment, right? I mean, Elon told us so himself.
There are very few people as an individual who have done more than I have to help the environment with electric cars.
The fact of the matter is that Elon Musk is either lying or remaining willfully ignorant about the real effects that Tesla has on this planet. When he announced his Tesla Gigafactory battery plant, he said that it would power itself with wind and solar energy.
Through a combination of geothermal, wind and solar, it will produce all the energy that it needs.
But in fact, it has lines connecting it into the same electrical grid that we are all using. But it doesn't stop there. The cars themselves demand an unfathomable amount of precious earth resources. Tesla's electric cars are dependent on rare earth metals. In mining these deep deposits, about 90% of what they pull up out of the ground contains uranium, thorium, and low levels of other radionuclides. This is radioactive waste which has to be disposed of somehow. What they usually do is kind of turn it into a paste and spread it all over the desert floor. Nice one, guys. I'm sure that's great for the desert and great for the environment. Tesla's electric cars are also built with aluminum, which uses 8 times more energy to manufacture than steel. They use lithium, which also relies on toxic mining, and even more graphite, which is one of the rarest forms of carbon. In fact, the investors of Tesla wanted to open several new graphite mines after Tesla announced its new gigafactory. All in the name of quote clean and green energy, which it turns out is neither cleaner nor greener than the fossil fuels they are trying to replace. Now the whole topic of how the clean and green movement pushed by people like Musk is a big scam is a very long topic that would take many hours to go in depth with, which I won't do in this specific video. I will however recommend this documentary called Planet of the Humans, which does a great job of exposing this fraud that we have all been led to believe is going to somehow save humanity. So give that a watch if you want to learn more about this topic. And this brings us to the last case in point, SpaceX. It has never been a secret to anyone that Elon's goal with SpaceX is to make humans a multi-planet species.
I think it's very important that we become a multi-planet species.
Thus, we could become a truly multi-planet species.
Becoming a multi-planet species.
But Elon, what about if we sort out this planet before we move on to other planets? Wouldn't that be the wisest thing to do? What if we focus our effort on this planet instead of building these massive rockets that can take us to other planets where we'll find all these new solutions and new areas of discovery? What if we focus on this planet first of all instead, which we are currently destroying, by the way? It makes absolutely zero sense to make humans a multiplanetary species when we are currently jeopardizing the only planet that we have called home thus far. And what happens when we do end up on Mars and destroy life on that planet too? Do we find the next planet to move on to? Do we do this until we have run through every major planet in the galaxy? Elon, if you really cared about the environment, you would stop these insane and deluded space missions and allocate resources to something that actually made this current planet a better and more fertile place to live. You would finance projects that support regenerative agriculture. You would help soil diversity. You would make sure the entire planet has clean and healthy water. You would do so many things that are not sending big, expensive, resource-sucking rockets on a one-way ticket to outer space. But of course, Elon has no interest in stopping any of this. Because this is not about our planet. It's not about saving you, it's not about saving me, it's not about saving any of us. It's not even about money or business. This is all about one thing. Elon's ego. These rockets are nothing more than a gigantic ego trip, created by an extremely rich and powerful man who gets off on the energy given to him by people who constantly hail him as a savior and a genius.
I do actually think that he was brought up in a kind of cult situation. If you look at his mother especially, I think he's completely brainwashed and been used. They will use people like him. I think he's been put in a position where he's been told he's a genius.
It's kind of funny to me, in a sort of morbid way, that all of the richest, most powerful, progressive businessmen of this era, like Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg and Jeff Bezos, are all obsessed about finding ways to get out of this reality. Elon and Jeff are doing this in the literal sense with their insane space projects, and Mark is doing it in a more sophisticated way by literally building a new reality with the metaverse. Why are these men so obsessed about leaving this planet behind? Why are they building apocalypse bunkers on the middle of an island? Are these really the cowards that we, the human race, should be putting our faith in?
With Elon, I think that it's easy to choose a savior when it's the one being served up on a silver platter with all the right voices telling you, yes, that's the one you should look at. Don't mind the man behind the curtain, right? Just clearly wanting you to go with this guy. And so I see why some people may fall into it. You know, they want to believe that, especially if they lean a certain way. I think the reason it's happening, though, is because a lot of people who don't care whether he's honest, who are invested in the two-party illusion or any number of different things that align with what their interests are and are willing to lie about that. Or willful ignorance to the extent that it doesn't matter. Like I said, it's really just about aligning with the kind of momentum behind a certain thing. And I think Elon Musk is quite obviously an effort to get ahead of what was a building momentum around the awareness of the Great Reset, of the completely currently collapsing mainstream corporate media. I mean, you can go down the list of every checkbox from the Great Reset, and he's in lockstep with all of them. Even the micro RNA factories in regard to Tesla, I mean, it's across the board. And brain-machine interface, the Starlink, the Neuralink, I mean, it's crazy. And so what's wild is you've taken people that were 30 seconds ago kind of in lockstep, you know, largely the right in this case, calling out all the Great Reset problems. It just shows you that these people aren't honest in their positions.
So Elon, here's what I want you to do. I want you to stop the madness. Go to Peru, find a trusted shaman, and let him do an ayahuasca therapy session with you. Then I'm sure you'll see that what you're doing to Mother Earth is a disgrace.